The epilogue. Aaron went to the United States, married, and became a successful businessman. Gunter and Gina also immigrated to the United States, where they have lived happily together for more than 50 years. Hans remained in England, received his degree as a physical therapist, and went on to win numerous national chess champions for the blind. After closing the hostel at Wildenson Lane, Miss Cohen lived with her son until her death at age 70. In the fall of 1949, Lisa Jura received a visa allowing her to immigrate to America. Michael Goblek, who had become one of the most decorated Jewish officers in the French Renaissance, followed soon after. They were married in New York in November 1949. They moved to Los Angeles, joining Rosie and Leo, who had settled there, and were followed by Sonia and her husband, Sol. The sisters remained in daily contact for the rest of their lives. In 1958, Lisa Jura, who was contacted by a long-lost cousin living in Israel, who wrote to her the truth of what happened to Malka and Abraham. The cousin had received Abraham's last known communication, a letter that had been written in January 1941 and had been rerouted around the world to Palestine. Abraham wrote of their impending deportation and employed the cousins with the words, "We are lost and beg you to look after our precious children." On April 14th, 1941, they were arrested by the Gestapo, taken from their home on the Frankenstrasse, and deported to Lodz. From there, they went to Auschwitz. Lisa Jura had two daughters, Mona and Renee, who grew up to fulfill their mother's dreams by becoming concert pianists. To this day, Mona continues to tell her mother's story on stages across the world. Lisa's three granddaughters, Michelle, Sarah, and Rachel, also play the piano. Her grandson, Yoni, plays the violin. In June 1999, Lisa's daughters and granddaughters were invited to be the featured artist at the 60th Worldwide Reunion of the Kinder Transport in London, performing the Clair de Lune on the BBC. Michelle and Rachel thanked Britain for saving Lisa's life and spoke of the precious words given to them by their grandmother and piano teacher. "Hold on to your music, it will be your best friend." And it continues to be.